Hi, I'm Dave for Cyderbaby and Rock Radio UK. I'm here today in my local pub across the road from Cyderbaby Towers with Hole Tripper. Hi, guys.
Hiya. How you doing?
Introduce yourselves.
I'm Jim.
I'm Ben.
Hi, guys.
Oh, you're a bone now, Dave.
yeah. Brothers, I believe.
We are indeed, yeah.
Yes.
So, from birth.
Okay. The same batch of eggs, or?
That's debatable, in fairness, isn't
okay,
it?
Okay, right, moving swiftly on. Okay, tell me about Hole Tripper. I mean, you approached me, I think, via the email system of the Rock Radio UK thing a while back, and you sent me some songs, and we had a chat, and yeah, this is sort of like the peak of it, having a little interview. Just tell me about Hole Tripper, because not everybody has heard of you.
There we go.
No, you go for it.
Okay, Hole Tripper, we're a 90s rock, early 90s rock influence band. Grunge is our was our staple. I think we both sort of found music at that time. So that was the key. So, you know, the Nirvana, Pearl Jam stuff, but also Reef, Rage Against the Machine, all those bands at that time, Soundgarden, all those wonderful bands. We just love that stuff. And as the music industry moved on, right, we just stayed exactly the same. And we stayed there for about 20 years, and that's where we continue to stay. And in that time, we just messed around making songs. We never really did anything. And then over lockdown and COVID, we decided to make a record because there's nothing else better to do. And so we just learn how to do everything. You know, we learn how to sing. I learned how to sing.
We
actually decided to learn the songs rather than just write them down and make them. Revolutionary for the band was actually learning the songs. I'm not kidding, because we never really learned them. We just make lots of songs, and then we never actually sit down together and actually get them to actually come to fruition.
Right.
So we did that, and we just we had fun, super fun. It was amazing fun making it, getting out from the head onto a piece of paper / record, whatever. Learned a lot, did a lot of stuff. Put one foot in front of the other. Found a bass player, found a drummer. Now we're doing live stuff.
Wow.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Never performed. I've overcome crippling anxiety performance. Anxiety like ludicrously bad. And now I've got over that. Pretty important as being the singer. I ain't gonna lie, fairly important to be able to be up there and do that stuff. And you know, you learn how to play guitar again.
Yeah.
And that's what we're doing. So yeah, we've been like 30-ish, 25 years in the making, but we've really sort of did nothing for 23 of those years. So it's a slow growth curve. But we're on it now. We're on it.
23 years, I know.
Maybe.
So when are we expecting the first album?
It's already out.
The first one. Yeah.
So we made that first one in our cupboards at home. And
under
we
the stairs?
It literally was. Cupboard under stairs one, cupboard under stairs two. That's our recording studios. And the next one, we're halfway through. But we made the first one under stairs, Harry Potter style.
Yeah.
And then the second one, we realised actually it's quite hard to actually produce music. So we now... It is actually quite hard. It's not as easy as it looks, even with the wonders of modern technology. One funny thing about, actually, in the 90s, our big challenge was...
Yeah.
Making it sound good. You'd have an old four track and we tried to get it, and everything sounded so terrible. But there were also no new bands because you had to actually be signed to do anything.
Hmm.
Whereas now it's a complete role reversal. Anybody can make anything sounding pretty decent with the tech that's around at the moment, which is great, which means we can do it from a cupboard under the stairs one, a cupboard under the stairs two, and make it sound as good as we could, which is solid. But obviously every bugger under the sun can do that too now. So you're in that position where...
How many songs is it?
60,000 a week in Spotify release. So standing out from the crowd is an interesting thing. To just try to... You know, there's an awful lot in the gutter.
Yeah.
Scrabbling around for not a lot. And
including
just,
us. Yeah.
Including us. We're and truly gutter dwelling at the moment. Which is getting one rung up. Requires, I think, just a slightly different approach.
Mm.
Just doing something. Obviously, you can write the phenomenal track, but with that much noise, you've just got to think quite creatively, I think, about how you can stand out. So.
Okay.
Yeah.
Anything you want to add to?
I think he's covered most of it there, didn't you? I mean, I bought a Marshall JCM 900 the other day, good 90s amp, and I explained everything Ben just said to the guy who bought it, 1996, and he said, you guys are a time capsule. And I thought, that sums us up. That literally sums us up, a time capsule. Because all this amazing music was written back in the 90s, parked up for literally 20, how many years?
20 years, yeah.
Yeah, probably. 20 years. And then it got dug up, and now we're smashing it.
We literally had a 10-year break, got to 30, had kids. Young kids, you haven't got time for side projects unless you want to be a bad father, basically. So if we're going to do that, we're both like, we've got kids now, ain't going
to
happen.
It really was. Right, we've got to get this album done by the time we're 30. We've got to get it done by the time we're 33. We've got to get it done. Oh, don't worry.
We hadn't actually learned the songs, of course.
No, we hadn't learned the songs at this point.
But we still knew we had to get it done by the time we're 30, though we'd never learned the songs until we're much later. And then actually, I gave everything away to stop doing anything, and then... Then I got to 40, and funny enough, 40, things change, and you go, I mean, in this day and age, one of the great things about being in 2023 is, I can't think of another time in history where you can do whatever the hell you want without getting, you know, the old rules of you've got to be 18 to do whatever you want to do. It's all gone now, so I may as well milk that puppy till the cows come out, because I genuinely believe age is no barrier. We both, frankly, are small walking man babies anyway. We've never really grown up, so we may as well carry on, and you know, we'll keep doing it now till we literally can't do it. I mean, now
being 22, we've got plenty of time left, don't we?
Plenty of time. Plenty of time, yeah.
Such a liar.
Hang on, facelift time.
Yeah. But you know, metabolically we're a lot younger than we could be, which is great. Keep going yourself and keep going, I think.
We're alive, aren't we? And we're doing it.
Right? Yeah.
Oh, back in the day, I used to look at people in their 40s as really old. Now I'm sort of 55, I'm thinking, I'm not that old.
I've changed my perspective on that as well, I think it's fair to say, Dave. Yeah, definitely changed my perspective on what old is. Right, like I say, I think 20 years ago, like, you know, I think it was different. I think starting, I mean, you know, then you look at, you know, bands who've just trolling out the same stuff and done it. They're just playing the same thing. They're like 50 or 60. The Stones. I just think it's good songs, good songs. And, it, you know, and I think that's the most important thing, just getting as good a product as you can.
Right, so you have an album out. Tell me a title and basically what it's like.
Do you want to do that one?
No, you go for it.
No, you go.
He's leaving it to you, isn't he?
Yeah, right, yeah, so the album is called 100 Miles at a Time.
Mm-hmm.
Reason for that is obviously two cupboards.
Yep.
100 miles away, Bristol, East Devon. Out of time is because Ben had a severe problem with keeping in time with the actual vocals.
Okay.
many funny stories of life.
Pro Tools Warp was an absolute saviour.
I've come a long way. Remember when we were starting again from essentially scratch. I had to teach myself how to sing. I was never planning to sing any of these songs. I just wrote them for fun. I always assumed
we were going to get a decent guitarist.
Yeah, we were.
Mm.
We were going to get a decent singer.
Yeah,
and then we were going to just sell it all.
Sell it or do something.
Or
with it.
Just not. Yeah, not just performing. Just
not doing anything.
Not performing a gig in Bristol and Festival in the Hills next year.
Yeah, it was never the plan to ever play live. Not in any possible reality that I think ever performing on stage, let alone actually sing the songs.
Funny thing is the recording site has gone out the window now, hasn't it? We're not even interested in it. Since we got Mikey and Ben, drummer and bass player, now all we want to do every Thursday, band practice, don't even bother about recording it. We are. But it's all about once you get that feeling of playing live. We'd never done it, have we?
Never done it. Never played with the band until 4 months ago.
Right.
Yeah, so we got Mikey in.
Yeah.
Me, Mike, and Ben, two practices. This sounds good. Then we got Ben in, the bass player.
That's amazing.
As soon as it all gelled together, that was
amazing.
It was just practice every Thursday and get as many gigs as we can.
Our big challenge is, well, we're quite time poor.
Yeah.
We've got real world.
Yeah, being 22.
We're not, you know, the great, I mean, when you know, we just got not a lot of time. In the old days, we had all the time in the world. Of course, didn't get anything done, funny enough, because stuff comes up. But we've got very little time now. So you've kind of got to prioritise one thing. I think one of the only thing I'd say is if you're going to just try and do one thing really well at a time, otherwise you end up just doing everything a bit mid. So when we were only making music, that's all we did. We spent hours and hours and hours on that stuff, trying to play live and practice and get any good. And and at the same trying to knock out tracks at home and then continue the real world activities you have to do is actually quite hard work. So something's got to give. So we're an oddities band, so we probably have albums worth of material
right.
done. It's yeah, all there.
That's what, 5 albums worth?
Yeah, we've just got a lot of stuff.
Yeah, done.
And that's been filtered through the funnel of crapness, you know, when you go, that's got to go, you know, it's not good enough. And over a long period of time as well. So, you know, you get a bit more discerning. So the product sort of isn't the problem. It's the time to get it done. It takes so long as well to make a song. So it takes so long to make a song.
Luckily, we've
it's
got
so long. So we just got to prioritise it. Playing live is just amazing. Now we can do it. It's a brilliant thing.
And unbelievably, like, we have actually managed to actually secure a couple gigs, haven't we?
We have. Yeah.
Which again, we weren't even supposed to have a band, like we said earlier. We weren't supposed to have a band until next year, were we? So we are leagues in front on the business plan, aren't we?
Yes, business plan. Well ahead. Ticking the box. Business plan. So first proper gigs in Bristol, the Louisiana, on right. 27th of January. We're mm-hmm. supporting a amazing band called Ava. And then we'll play Festival in the Hills in Harleston in June. Amazing.
Unfortunately, our favourite band of all time is Reef.
Yes.
We just found out Reef are headlining on Thursday night, but we're on the Saturday night, which is a real shame.
We would have haunted them backstage. We would have haunted them.
I've haunted Reef backstage.
We never want to meet your heroes. There's normally a disappointment, but we would have haunted those guys.
We literally used to watch those lads when they were playing in pubs.
We really did.
We watched them grow right to the Fistral gig.
Yeah, we did. Yeah.
And that was just like the best gig I think they'd ever done. And we're on the same stage as them. I phoned the band, guys, we're on the headliners. And Ben, the bass player, they're on Thursday, we're on Saturday.
Booked to be on Friday.
Yeah.
But they sort of put Billy Ocean as well.
Yeah.
So to just shuffle Reef back a bit.
We have got Billy Ocean Saturday night, haven't we? That's a hell of a achievement, actually.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I saw Reef headline the Custom Blues Festival back in 22, which is in Derbyshire. And they're a really, really good band there.
Yeah.
And of course, they've brought out a recent album.
Yeah.
But they're quite keen on the smaller bands such as yourself, because at the time I was speaking to Muddy Brook, who's a very much a three-piece grunge outfit, and Jack was having Muddy Brook as a support, but he fell ill at the time, and now I believe they're playing together as well, so they kept in touch after that festival, and Jack actually gave him a shout out during the gig as well, because they were there. So you say never meet your friends. I mean, your musical style would suit them on a future tour, I reckon.
Yeah, I think they
Jesus
would.
Christ,
can you send that to them?
Yeah, I will. Yeah.
Because they're Glastonbury band. We grew up in Wellington, in Somerset, so we just saw them so many times.
They were
starting out. Fishing Beach, we sit at the Cavern, we saw them at Pilton Party.
Saw them a few times at the Cavern.
Yeah, I've still got a scar that I was chopped off at the Pilton Party up. I looked up at Gary the singer, and he just looks at me like, you. hobbled off, bleeding out my leg. But I got my Reef scar. So no, I referenced tracks when we were doing our own.
Yeah, I referenced everything to
Reef, Rage, Rage Against the Machine. On one level,
it's a bit more Reefy, but that needs a bit more ragey. I was like, I don't really know how to do this.
If we confuse the band we want to be, it will be Reef Rage. Rage.
Yeah,
that's the band. But the reason I think we like the early 90s so much is because there's a strong acoustic element to a lot of those American grunge bands, particularly so the Pearl Jam's, the Bars. I know they're quite I don't know, they've gone different tracks. The Nirvana obviously capitulated. Foo Fighters I can't stand. Pearl Jam went down a path I really didn't want them to go down.
But it was their path, wasn't it?
But it was their path, and now I understand they've got to do what they've got to do.
Yeah.
Frankly, I'm pretty mad with them still. They decided to go, I wrote on the website, I'm going to rant about them actually. Not that they care. I'm sure Eddie Vedder's too busy doing his own thing.
He knocked Eddie out of his contacts and everything.
Eddie, we're not talking again. Stop it, man. After album 4, come on. on? What are you doing to me? Anyway,
but they were also a lifeline Belgium back in the early days. Teddy versus Vitality was a
But I love the fact they.
But we're not stuck in the '90s.
No. So our stuff is there. But I think if you just try and go back and like to start, we probably try to replicate our first effort. Just try to replicate the sound. It's rubbish. It's someone else's sound. So what we do want to try and do is we love that thing.
Mm.
But if you're not going forward, you're going backwards. So let's try and just push it on a bit.
Try and make it more sound like Old Tripper.
Yeah, and try to establish your own thing, which hopefully is similar but not the same. Otherwise, it's just, you're a wannabe crappy cover band, you know. There's never on cover bands, but if you want to make your own music, don't just sound like someone else exactly. Try to at least carve out a micro niche in the thing. Otherwise, you know, what are you doing it for? So, but we do love all that acoustic stuff, but the band, they just want to play really heavy stuff. Like, no, we're not playing that one. We're playing, we want Audio Slave and Rage.
Yeah.
Ben and Mikey, they're just brutes.
A couple of grunges, aren't they?
They really are. So
brutes,
it's like,
they are.
A brute. So, well, what about this one? No, we're not playing that. Save that for when you're really old. Yeah. You can knock out the acoustic stuff later on. So, we'll have to wait for all that stuff, I think.
Yeah.
Which is a shame. Because I like it all. I like the whole spectrum. I don't think you should have to just play one thing. I think you should play the whole thing.
We must have 50 acoustic chilled songs. Look.
Okay.
That you could do.
Yeah, they're all good. Yeah,
acoustic guitar, vocals, nothing else.
Yeah.
Or you could do it as a band. But at the minute, we're full set. Heavier the better, aren't we?
Yeah, while we can.
While we can,
we're rocking it. Until
before you get a mic, it's
you. Yeah, exactly. 22's a hard age.
22's a tough age.
Oh, and the rest of it, you just don't know. So, the vision then, you've got 2 gigs booked. I assume you want to get touring as well, get some more gigs booked. You've got 1 album out at the moment. Is there plans to record a few more of your storage of tracks?
Well, our plan was to release 1 single a month.
Right.
Every 6 weeks, but I think we're going to cut that down to every 12 weeks, aren't we?
Yeah,
at the minute.
It's just something's got to give. So yeah. That'll have to give.
We've got 3 ready in the bag to be released at the minute.
Okay.
Of the next album, that'll make how many in the album?
We're up to about 7. We're doing it the new way. We release every single song.
Yeah.
Because
right or wrong, that's what.
Because we haven't got any marketing budget to spend loads of money. And we have no intention of ever being signed.
How long did you spend on the album order?
Yeah, the album order. It's important. But we just want to release everything because actually otherwise we've got absolutely nothing to say.
Yeah. Yeah.
You actually need something to say. And we can't just put an album out release to do it the traditional way. So we're doing it the kind of new DIY musician way. Quite like every single song is a single. And actually, I haven't realised just how long it takes to do it, how much it costs to do it. I think you're right. We wouldn't be doing it if they weren't decent. But I'd love to do it the old way. Do 2 singles, do a whole album, then go away and write another one.
Yeah.
It's just getting the priority of it, really. I think
you're finding now that album tracks are getting lost.
Yeah.
Many people I've interviewed, they release an album, they say, the first song gets the most hits and the second song gets the second most. When you get to song 9, song 10, hardly anybody's heard them.
Yeah.
Because they just switched off or they've put shuffle on or whatever. So you're right. He who must not be named over there was actually right for a change.
I just think it's... It just takes time. And also, what I would say, you just never know what songs people are going to like. The ones I like the most are the ones that I never played now. I mean, I'm not kidding. The ones that you always say, mate, that's the one we're going to like. Man, that's mid. Like, that's just okay. And he's like, no, people are like that. And
I'm usually
Nori
right.
Bryan.
Annoyingly.
And I write all sorts of stuff. I love doing it. Well, we do it together. We've got a.
We're both wrong, aren't we? Because our favourite track at the time, which was Breathe Easy, track number 6 or something. absolutely ridiculed for. Absolutely ridiculed by everybody. It's our least.
Least popular North plays that we've had people.
It's had 60 views, I think. Yeah. Okay. 60 Spotify
we
plays.
We loved it. We loved it the most. To be fair, it was probably better than the original.
We're playing it in band practice tonight as well.
We are, first time.
Okay.
So when we do our live stuff, because we've got the luxury of all these, just because half of the songs which we'll play in our live set, we haven't released. Because they're frankly better than the ones we've released so far. And the band like it more. So we'll probably end up playing a lot of the new stuff that isn't released live because we can, you know, do you know what I mean? So we have quite a big back catalogue to go from, although it's not actually back catalogue that exists in the universe yet. So it's kind of a funny situation, really. So like I say, with songs, you know, like it or not, you know, who cares? Music's subjective. We've got all sorts of people. You do need a bit of a, you know, we have to wake up a bit to the old, take it on the chin. You send your stuff out there. And you know, 99.
We did review of the week for a while, didn't we?
Yeah, we did.
The best one we had was, "This is just bad."
Yeah, we did. So we love that stuff. Yeah. So we had all the worst things that people have said, and then we just post it. It's hilarious, you know. It's just
constructive criticism.
Yeah, well, it wasn't even constructive. I think it's we just think it's funny. So the objective of the band is now just to have fun. So there is no other objective really, other than obviously when we're doing something, I think we're going to do something. We just want to be the best it could be. That was the point. But you know, we sort of just playing is a wonderful thing. So you know, when we play, I think we just want to. You know, the objective is to just, you know, not be quite.
When we play, we go to Wembley, don't we? Every Thursday.
We go to Wembley. We do. Every Thursday. We're there in our heads. So yeah. It's just always. It's all a bit good fun. Rather than the, you know, we don't get to a certain point and you stop caring what people think about you. As I think if I was doing this when we originally wrote them, knowing me, rewind all that time, psychologically, you know, wouldn't have been possible to do it. Because, you know, you get to something you don't really care. As long as you know you're doing it, just trying to do the best stuff you can do. Plus, I was incapable of singing back then. It's taken me 20 years now to sing. So I literally never thought I would ever sing, ever. I mean, literally, it was never a part of the plan.
It was never the intention to sing.
The intention was just to write them for the fun of writing a song. For me, it's the creative element of writing a song is the real fun. So that's the fun. Playing it now is, who knew how much fun it could actually be when the four of us get it right. Yeah, it's nothing quite like it. I never knew what people were talking about when I made that shit up.
Chemistry.
I thought they made it up. It's true. It's a true thing. It's like, wow, look at that. What we're missing all these years. What was I waiting for? Moron. This is true. What was I thinking?
You've got plenty of years ahead of you, you know. 40 years, man. So, you know, Rolling Stones still going. 233.
Yeah.
Did watch a hilarious YouTube thing. I know it was messing around on some singing practice thing. Yeah. And said, am I too old to be in a band? Oh, brilliant. Clicked on this. There were these two bods. It must have been about 40 themselves, having a nice old natter about each other. And they were saying, yeah, I don't think there's ever an age you can pop in a band. And they carried on. I thought, this is great. This is just the boost I need. And then they didn't go, yeah, I think, though, you know, once you get past 30, I think you're delete.
Yeah.
Wrote a nice comment. No, it's all good. We as I said, there's never been a better time in the history of mankind to do stuff at completely inappropriate ages compared to where you want to be. And this is a wonderful time to exist in the world for that, because everyone's so accepting they can pretty much do whatever the hell you want. So what a wonderful thing. And I think that sort of whole judgmental side seems to be evaporating from the world. I mean, whether it's going to go completely is always in the world. But, you know, as I say, get a bit of a thick skin. And march on. Keep going.
Okay, well, I'm not going to take up too much more of your time. Hole Tripper, the band. You can find your music
Everywhere.
Everywhere.
Yeah.
You're spamming the hell out of everything.
Yeah.
We try not to spam. One of our we try not to spam too much. Like, you know, we put it on all the releases thing. I just we did a bit of spam in the early days. And didn't go down somewhere.
We did always say all our music will always be free, didn't we?
Yeah, it'll always be free. Yeah.
Yeah. We'll always gig for free.
Right.
Yeah. Our music will always be free on our website or on Spotify. We're never going to charge for our music.
And when we do charge, we'll then find creative and interesting ways to give it away. So when we play, we'll apparently you have to sort of sometimes get paid because people look at you like you're mad. But we'll take that money. Our plan is to think of, you know, wonderful ways to kind of give it back, whether it's buying everyone in the pub or the gig.
In Bristol, whatever we make, we're just going to buy everyone a pint. Everyone in the crowd who comes to see us, we'll buy them a pint with many tickets.
Festival on the Hills, we'll get
to. We might go and buy everyone a pint there.
Could be quite expensive.
We'll be thinking of a funny way to give some stuff away. So it'll be fun to see what we can come up with. I think we'll see how we go with that. But that's the plan anyway.
Okay. You've got a website then, obviously. So
website's up. All good.
Yeah, what's the address?
Holtripper.com.
Simple.
It is. Yeah, holtripper.com.
Spreadsheet, got a database.
Got business plan.
We were talking about this earlier about your spreadsheets and business plans.
Yeah.
When you then say all your music is going to be free, that's not really a business plan, is it?
Well, it depends on what your criteria for a successful business is. So, you know, in the old days, so in the real world, my business plan is absolutely geared towards, you know, making sure we've got a viable thing. But this business has a completely different set of objectives. So we are break even. We'll never make break even. We spent an absolute fortune on this band.
Oh, yeah.
We've made about 12 quid so far. So
it's 25 grand.
This is genuinely for, this is for the fun and the love. And there's no aspiration. If we do make money, we'll just find interesting ways of giving it away, is the plan.
Invest in a radio station.
Invest in a radio station, yeah.
On that bombshell, Holtripper, thank you very much.
Cheers. Amazing. Cheers.